SiriusXM. The Opie and Anthony Show.
I'm going hungry. I'm hungry.
For Kennedy. I know you're out there somewhere, Kennedy.
This one's for you.
This one's for you.
You know what's got a good voice?
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
You know it's so odd? It's such a, like, how the little world works. My sister is, she's like a fucking regional manager of some fucking clothing shit that she does, whatever. Useless fucking job. I'm teasing, of course. I love my sister, Dwayne.
That's her thing.
That's her thing. She's
been
done
doing
very,
that forever.
Very well over the years.
Right.
She works with Dennis Falcone's daughter.
No kidding.
How the fuck does that happen? Isn't that weird?
She just discovered this?
Yeah, they just figured it out.
Sal's been talking. Every time Sal sees Dennis, he talks about wanting to fuck his daughter. So
oh, Jesus.
A big coincidence there.
Well, now there's
what?
An in.
Sal wants to?
Yeah, he does.
Oh, does Dennis have pretty daughters?
I guess Sal.
How old are they?
How about we leave his daughter alone because she's a civilian? Yeah. Jesus Christ.
Oh, I'd be okay with that. It's okay.
Or at least ask the father.
Well, I think it's all right.
Sal doesn't want to fuck anything that has a vagina. We all know that by now.
At least you don't have to worry about pregnancy. He can't seem to fucking orgasm.
Where is Dennis Falcone?
That's Falcone.
We wanted him on the second day in Montreal just to see how we were doing.
Yeah, with the...
Maybe we could get a little review of our Kennedy interview from him.
That's why I do it right
Jesus.
There. That's why.
He's on his way up.
Is he?
Why wouldn't you?
Come right in.
That's why I do it. I gave up on Boba until I realized that it really bothered Jimmy, and then for some twisted fucking reason, I was back in.
Right. Yeah, yeah.
Just to see Jimmy's face when he knows Bobo's on the line.
Bobo. Isn't that kind of weird, though? You're just like,
that is weird.
It's a giant fucking, giant nation we live in, and there it is. Bang. What are we losing our interns soon, huh?
Tomorrow we lose Sydney.
Sydney's and my last day together, and she's writing about that on Facebook, tear-stricken.
Aw, tear-stricken. Yeah.
It's titled tear-stricken.
Yeah.
Oh, here's Dennis Falcone. Oh. He's right at the door.
Isn't Nick DiPaolo calling in today?
Nick?
Yeah. No?
He was gonna. I don't know.
What happened? Okay. Might have Nick on.
Hey. There
What's
he
up,
is.
Kid? Oh, wait. Here's your walk-on music.
Yeah.
And how I got the job as an FM jock the day you married me. It was two kids and I was into AM rock, but I just had to run around.
Hi, Dennis. Hello, Jim. How are
you? Like this song, Dennis?
Yeah, good song.
Yeah. Let me tell
you
about what's
down. Did you hear our interview with Kennedy?
Yes, that was good. Good
terrific,
stuff.
Right?
Oh, stuff. Good.
Did we ask all the pertinent questions?
She didn't seem as wild as her persona.
I know, right? That surprised me. It took me aback a little bit.
She was
a
great talker, though, like a really funny. Some people are just really interesting to listen to, and she was really interesting to listen
Absolutely.
To.
Absolutely.
Yes, and how do we do with the music tie-in? She was, talked about a little music. That's always good. We could have done some kind of talk about some of the stations here. Like, oh, she talks about something in the 90s. We could have been like, well, you could hear that on, Lithium.
You did a great job.
Yeah, I should have done that. I should have plugged Lithium.
Yeah, you should. When she said Lithium, the song. She said the song Lithium.
Hey, and by the way, we have a station right here.
Station.
He means that.
Oh,
assholes.
I know he does.
Yeah, you really should have. You missed your tie-in. You missed your tie-in to the company you work for.
Are you going out to sing karaoke with your sister tonight?
I hear there's a big karaoke thing going on tonight.
I was showing my daughter the Vine.
I said, oh, this is, you know, Anthony's place. And she goes, wait a second, I know that girl. And she goes, that's, you know, and she works with her. I said, what? I said, yeah, I guess that's just, I said, well, I'll ask Anthony how he knows this girl.
Yeah.
So then she texts me the next day. She goes, it's his sister.
Sister, yep. Yeah. And then I guess
she
they were.
She wants karaoke.
I guess they were out last night or something.
What, they
or
hang maybe, out?
No, like it was a company thing.
Oh, okay.
She put together a karaoke thing. I said, well.
Yeah, let me see. It says, I'm out with some work peeps doing charity karaoke. One of my managers from one of the stores. Proceeds to tell me that her dad works with you at Sirius. I was like, who's your dad? She said, Dennis Falcone.
That's weird.
That's funny. It's a small world.
Very small world.
It really is. It's getting smaller all the time.
You never know, so you never want to burn a bridge.
See? Yeah, that's good advice.
Very sage advice.
Yes.
By the way, you guys did a great job in Canada last week.
That was the Montreal shows. Those really were good, right?
It was really good.
I think we have a highlight podcast.
Yes, it went up yesterday.
Went up yesterday. So if you missed our Montreal shows, we got a quick Opie and Anthony podcast. Oh, an hour of the highlights from the Montreal trip.
And some very funny comics that were on for the first time.
Very funny. You got the midget?
I think he made it, yes.
Brad Williams?
I think John Mulaney.
John Mulaney was hilarious.
Maybe some,
everyone was great.
Chris
everyone.
Stefano from Day 2.
That was good.
Yeah. Day 2, right? Day
I think
one,
when they
so
rebuild
much.
Your studio, you should have it set up like with the couch.
The
that
couch
would be nice.
Worked
They're
very
not rebuilding
well.
Anything.
They kind of got rid of an old phone. That's good.
It's a step
and
in
the
right direction.
Step in the right
direction. The monitor got pushed down there.
Yeah, the monitor just too. Like pushed down. But
and then I was told it's a work in progress. By
Yeah. Don't worry about it.
Eric just told me where the old phone is.
Where?
They shoved it in Eric's studio. It's right next to his feet.
Oh, good.
Oh, yeah. Boy.
Oh, yeah, whatever works.
It's great. Get a feed on it.
Falcone.
Yes,
sir.
I want to ask you about Anthony Weiner. I know you don't work blue, but how would you handle that on your radio show?
Yeah, would you talk about the fact that he's all these cock pictures popping up?
Right.
He shouldn't be doing that if he wants to run for office.
Well, they all do it, though.
Sound advice. Words of wisdom.
Yeah, he shouldn't be working blue either.
I don't think he's going to get the nod.
Huh?
I don't think he's going to get the nod.
Of course not.
No, I don't think so either.
Get the nod.
You can't have a mayor coming five times a day.
No, I do enjoy that little fight, though, going on between one of his interns.
Fuck, we blew that off.
And the assistant that he had working with him, who apparently are both kind of attractive, I think. I think they both were, but they were they're slinging some mud. Talking about calling one of them a fucking the C word. I want to say what Dennis is here. And a whore or slut.
Do you know what the C word is, Dennis?
Oh, yeah.
You do?
I don't like that word.
Oh,
no. It's a great one.
Love it.
I would be playing the Oscar Mayer Wiener jingle all the time.
Well.
Kids marching and stuff.
I wish there was an Oscar Mayer Wiener. Hey, another. Another Anthony Weiner story in the news.
And that whenever you talk about him, that comes up.
Yes.
What are some of the great Dick songs of all time?
Sort of like the Quack Quack. Let me see. Dick songs.
Yeah. That's not blue, because they were actual songs. You know, with that double entendre and shit.
Well, remember Shaving Cream?
Shaving Cream?
Buddy Bell?
No.
Yeah, it was a double entendre.
Was it a big hit?
Yeah.
And you say entendre. You're one of those guys?
There he goes. Yeah. You know,
I have a sad story to tell you.
What's this?
It may hurt your feelings a bit. Last night when I walked into my bathroom, I stepped in a big pile of shaving cream.
It's one of these
Be
songs.
Nice and clean. Shave every day and you'll always
It's like my ding-a-ling, Chuck Berry.
I thought he was going to say shit.
Yeah.
Right. You see the double entendre. So he took
entendre.
One more.
Her antics are queer, I'll admit. Each time I say, darling, I love you, she tells me that I'm full of shaving cream.
Oh.
Be nice and clean.
What year is this?
Shave
this is
like every early, day.
Early 50s, I think.
You know who kept his style going, Anthony?
Who?
It could have been managed by the Our same guy. Red Peters.
Red Peters.
How's your whole
family?
Suck on a stiff cock.
Tell with me.
Scorch loved that
song. Oh, really? Here it is.
Every Friday.
How's your home? What?
Okay.
Oof. Oh, wow. I could have thought. Yes. How's your home? Family.
How is your whole family?
Novelty song.
Yes, exactly. How's your whole family? Maybe a Dr. Demento song.
Right, right.
Do you like this, Sam?
I'm getting flashbacks to Syracuse.
You think it's funny?
We played it.
Hey.
A lot?
At AF, we played it. We thought we were funny playing this.
How'd you hold?
Yeah, I was like,
this was one of our Friday songs. We played it for a while.
Funny Friday? Is that what you called it?
Oh, how's your dick?
Dictation. What?
Dick?
Oh, but he goes with dictation?
Dictation
that's
machine.
A stretch.
The fuck is that?
But like in the 90s, these songs were like big. People like this stuff.
What's a dictation machine?
Exactly. How's your dir? Idjable. How's your dir? Idjable.
It's old. Why don't you take your pants down to the cleaners today?
Oh,
see?
I got it.
Yeah.
Musical interlude.
Yeah, fuck a kid.
Kind of cute.
Nap victim.
But that's just as
bad. Oh, not actually do his ass.
Oh, wow. Astrological chart.
That would get us in trouble with the FCC.
Bite my clit, Taurus, you cunt.
No. I think you're missing the gist of how this works, Jimmy.
They might play this on Blue Collar Comedies.
Good for them.
They would play.
I don't even know what Blue Collar Comedy is. I have no idea. Never listened to it.
It's funny.
Why?
They have a lot of Jeff Foxworthy on there.
Oh, very good.
Larry the Cable Guy.
He has a big finish. What? No, I guess we don't get it.
Family.
Ah, that great big hole.
Come on. Dennis, how? One of the greatest dick songs of all time.
Your home.
I really didn't do any show prep on this, but if I knew that was the topic.
What about Stroke It? Is that a dick song? Is that one of the big dick songs of all time?
I guess so.
Stroke Me?
No, Stroken by Clarence Carter.
Oh. What about Stroke Me? Stroke Me.
Stroke Me, that's one of the great dick songs of all time. Stroke Me.
I think that's a good one.
It was the time.
What about Squeeze My Lemon and Make the Juice Go Down My Leg?
Squeeze Box. The
All right, or you talk about what you want to.
Yeah, I guess it was a couple of things.
Suck on My Big 10 Inch.
That's one of the greatest dick songs of all time. Possibly the greatest.
Oh, suck on my big 10-inch.
Yeah.
Fucking pecker.
No. Chip doesn't get it either.
I'm missing the point.
The gist is, you know, you make
it's
something
gotta be
else
subtle.
Of
it's
it,
gotta
Chip.
Be subtle.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
That's good, right?
No, not really. No, Chip isn't very good. Big Balls, AC/DC.
There you go. One of the great dick songs of all time.
Detachable penis.
What's wrong with you, Dennis? You should know this shit.
Okay. Well, he's got it up on the screen here. It's not he's coming off the top of his head.
But you're more of an oldies guy.
I said My Ding-a-ling before.
My Ding-a-ling.
And said that was his only number one song, too.
And it stinks.
He'd like to get shit on, right?
Ding-a-ling.
I heard he used to lay under a coffee table and fucking chicks would drop deuces on the top of it.
You know that, right, Dennis? You just don't want to talk about, right?
I have no
idea. You've heard
the
rumors.
He'd lay under the table and Will would take a big shaving cream. Fucking. That's awful.
Jimmy laughs at glass tables, by the way.
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
Child's play.
Yeah, for what? Glass table.
That's stupid,
what do you play? Fucking have a cat with a fucking football helmet on? Man up. Shaving cream. I'm going to think of it all day.
Shaving.
See, it's a funny song. It stays with me.
Yeah. It does stay
Fill
with
my
it.
Cunt with shaving cream.
I always feel like I need a shower after I leave.
Yes.
E-Rock told me that was a big Morning Zoo song. I never heard that one before in my life.
Really?
Shaving cream?
Yeah. You've heard it before?
Never.
Oh, okay.
Never.
I never did.
Shaving cream. I'm sure E-Rock also remembers Eugene. Oh. Remember that one? Remember Eugene?
No, there's my an actual list, Dennis. Actual list. It's the top 10 dick songs of all time. What do we got on the list there, Sam Roberts?
Well, Big Balls was said.
Is that number one?
Yeah. I don't know if it's in any specific order.
Oh, they can't commit to an order?
Top 10 penis songs.
Hot Dog and a Shake by David Lee Roth.
Really?
Monster by Fred Schneider.
What?
God.
There's a monster in my pants, and it does a little dance. That song.
I don't know that one. We should hear it.
That song.
That song.
That song.
Yeah.
Can I hear it?
There's a monster in my pants, but it's not as Whack big as off. Ants.
This is it?
Yeah?
Yeah. This is a big alternative song.
Oh, this sounds very 80s.
Yeah.
A little Miami Vice.
Yes.
You can picture driving.
Probably play this on First Wave here at Sirius XM.
Good for that.
Ah.
Gives a fuck.
I don't know what First Wave is.
This is soundtrack to bad 80s sitcom, action show.
Action, yeah.
Yeah. Hardcastle and McCormick.
Yeah. Cagney and Lacey.
Yeah, yeah.
You know? Cagney has to go. She has an eight ball stuck in her twat. She's through the emergency room.
Sounds like B-52's a little bit.
Yeah,
a little bit. Oh, it is the guy.
Yeah.
B-Rock has to tell me it's the guy. I didn't.
The Love Shack, baby.
Monster! Monster! Oh, it's B-52's.
It's the B-52.
All right, enough. I don't give a fuck.
This was one of his solo efforts.
Good for him.
With the rest of the B-52s, so it's B-52s.
Right. He just had an attitude that year.
What else is on the calendar?
Today, by the way, the Opie and Anthony show, I'm doing a solo show today.
Okay.
This is the Anthony show.
Your solo project?
Yeah, we're all hanging out
right.
and doing the same exact thing,
but it's
my solo show.
Pompous assholes.
Fucking bullshit.
Like
fucking
those four solo Kiss albums.
Oh, shit. Now you're
all released
now
on the same day with the same cover. That was actually brilliant.
Yep.
Yeah, you like that?
Yeah, because it was still done as a band.
Yeah. Who had the weakest album?
Gene.
Gene Simmons, right?
I think so, yeah.
A lot of people say that.
Aces, I think, was the best.
What song?
New York Groove.
What song did Ace have on?
Yeah, New York Groove.
Oh, fucking, okay. Right there is worth the price of admission.
Yeah. Oh, wait, what was the one he fucking opened with? Oh, my God.
And Peter Criss had Beth, right?
No, that was off Destroyer.
Oh.
Peter Criss is...
That was a group effort.
Oh.
Yeah. No, it wasn't.
Well, it was still,
how dare
it was
you?
Well, Kiss, though,
we had Peter Criss in. He'll tell you it wasn't a fucking group effort.
Right, but it was still
and that Gene tries to take
Kiss.
A little credit for that song because he right. called it. Okay. What was the name of the song
it
originally?
Was Beck.
Beck.
Oh,
instead
yeah.
of Beck.
Gene had to go. I just made a little correction on the song. I said you should call it Beth.
And it became a huge hit.
And it became a huge hit because of me.
And apparently, people have called him a lying sack of shit. After that, yeah.
We're passing on them, right?
I hope not. I'll take them for the boner.
Oh.
Gene and Paul?
You got many radio shows they could go on.
What, the after show?
Yeah.
Jimmy's Boneyard show.
I know there's one they won't go on.
What?
In the Opie and Anthony show.
Oh, they said no to us?
No. That's you guys. Oh.
You guys don't like Kiss?
Yeah, I love Kiss. Leg it up!
I think when Gene had a problem with Danny... typing too hard was the day I turned on Gene Simmons.
So probably the only song Jimmy doesn't like is I Was Made for Loving You, right?
Dynasty, that was okay.
You don't like that? The disco, fucking disco Kiss?
Fucking 2000 Man came off of that, which is a fucking kind of a cover of a song.
Made for Loving You. That was like disco.
Yeah.
All right, what about the dick songs?
Penis Song by Monty Python.
Penis Song.
How's that good?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Here's a little number I tossed up recently in the Caribbean. Doesn't it awfully nice to have a penis?
Not right.
Isn't it frightfully good to have a
penis? Enough.
Oh, but that's not a double entendre.
Well, he's singing that, though, in a lounge. He's playing piano in a very fine establishment.
Yeah,
I never got it. I fucking hated
Monty Python. Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
There was a couple good skits, but...
Love Gun, Kiss.
Oh, Love Gun.
Jimmy, she came up with Love Gun.
Yeah, I missed that one.
I didn't think of it. You pulled the trigger of my Love Gun.
Yeah.
What else?
My Weena by Bowling for Soup.
All right.
Pink Thing, XTC. Oh. He's My Best Friend by Jellyfish.
What?
Wow. Sledgehammer, Peter Gabriel.
Ah.
How about they go with songs most people know of?
Well, yeah, that's what happens when you try to
come up.
I mean, Sledgehammer we know, obviously.
Yeah. It's a hit.
Of course, Detachable Penis was named. Yeah. That's it.
King Missile.
Although I'm seeing that Macklemore has a song called Penis Song.
Macklemore?
Oh, yeah.
Get Macklemore in here. like a 50s character. Get Macklemore in here now.
I love this guy again. Macklemore.
I love you.
Macklemore in my office.
There you go.
See? Yeah. I think you're right.
God, I want to just take you home as a pet.
You guys are
really entertaining.
Thank you very much for all your
Can't lose the Macklemore account.
yeah, it is very, yeah, I like it.
Anything else, Dennis or Denny,
no,
or whatever
man.
The hell you go by?
Well, whatever. Hey, I'm again, just a blast hanging out with you guys.
What are you doing today? I see no clipboard.
Working, doing some music logs, doing some programming.
Those music logs.
They're really important.
Yeah. They actually, love logging that music.
Because that music really
That's what
changes.
Chuck Berry liked in this face.
Actually getting a jump on the Christmas music, you know, just want to get ahead of things.
What?
Yeah, you know, just
That's crazy.
Well, how does the Christmas music change from year to year? Can't you just grab the playlist
the same
from,
shit. Yeah,
just
exactly.
Just want to make sure we're playing the, you know, the biggest version, so when we're ready to go on that, we're
we're ready to go on that.
More advanced planning than anything else
Have
that goes on in this
Have you ever advanced
place.
Plan for this radio show?
Oh, my God.
You know that
no.
first hour was a surprise to me?
Hey, surprise to everybody.
I came in here really tired. I'm like, oh, fuck, man. And then we ended up having a pretty good hour.
It's
but we
just...
didn't know we were going to talk about that shit.
And he's, you know... Christmas,
planning ahead.
Planning Christmas music.
Well, it's like I'm on Sunday nights on the 60s on 6. And
right.
You know, if there's stuff, I'll, you know, during the week, I'll just put some show prep together.
Just
so,
roasting on an open fire.
You got to remember, you're playing the same music basically all the time on the Decades channel. And so you have to come up with different stuff. You just can't
well.
Say, it's the Rolling Stones. Well, yeah, no kidding, it's the Rolling Stones. But, you know, come up with something different about Under My Thumb. You know, like I think 2 weeks ago, Keith Richards says he'd like to tour again in another 10 years. You know, he was doing an interview, and I said, "Can you imagine that? Well, they'll be 80 then, right?
Yeah, yeah.
It was just 70,
right? And then what happened? The
that
song
was the whole
started.
Break. Well, yeah, because I had an eight, you know,
you just did a math equation.
Ramp.
Well, no,
you
like,
did a
I
math equation.
Said, you know, by the way, he was on, you know,
70 plus 10 is 80.
Yeah.
Here's Under My Thumb.
Yeah, 18
so
second ramp.
So if you miss now, they'll have a 60th their reunion in 10 years.
There's a great version of Under My Thumb, a live version from some show that they used to do a TV. Show like this, it's so can you? It's a fucking
Top of the Pops or something.
Yeah, it was one of those. Yeah. And Mick Jagger, he looks like every alternative guy today.
Stop it was in that documentary that was out recently. I know what you're talking about.
Hullabaloo.
That's a great song.
They were really young.
Yeah, and Mick, it's a really weird version, but he's just doing this like, weird little. It's black and white. Of
did
course.
You hear the version of that song by the Who on
no.
Odds and Sods? Yeah, they did that because remember there was a time when the Rolling Stones weren't allowed to record or something, or there was. No, they were
really,
yeah, and the Who did a great version of that song. Matter of
wow.
fact, we played it last week. On the-
is that Martha Quinn?
Now to the fantastic Rolling Stones.
Yeah,
this is awesome.
He looks like
Jimmy's
every
right.
Hipster today look, wants to look like Mick Jagger.
Oh my God! This is so. What a weird guy.
No lip syncing there.
The girl. Oh.
I just saw him in the gym.
This was Ready, Steady, Go.
Get down on me.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. The way she talked when she spoke.
Like doing like some weird thing.
He was the fucking coolest, man, but now he looks just weird.
He's a bad dude, man. He looks
Look
like
at the girl. Wow,
she's fainting.
She's fainting.
You think he could have fucked her?
Oh, he could have fucked him.
Chicks fucking drugged up. They all look like they're in their like early 30s and they're like 13. Look at this chick is losing her fucking mind. Jeez. The xylophone. Whoever knew the Stones? It's like, yeah, I was the xylophone player for the Stones for a little while. What?
And the Stones still sounds good after all these years. It
yeah.
stands up.
Yes,
man.
It does.
You Stones guy?
Love
him. You can't not like this. You can't watch this and not think he's fucking the coolest guy on the fucking planet.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's good.
But now he doesn't say me anymore.
Meh!
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 Oh, my two!
Under my
two! Meh!
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 Oh,
my two!
Is he the best dancer ever, though? Look at his dance. It's the greatest dancer ever.
Everyone imitated him.
It's like a little pee-pee dance.
Chris Robinson completely stole his moves.
Oh, really?
Oh, God, yeah.
Is that a me?
Meh! Meh!
Oh my God!
He doesn't say two anymore either.
No.
Ta,
three,
ta.
How many loads has come out of that cock since this was recorded on Strange Girls?
They wanted to wear the black hat there.
Like moshing almost in that pit.
And they were more middle class than the Beatles were, the poor ones.
Keith Richards explained it. He goes, we want to wear the black hat. We let the Beatles have the white hat.
Look at the audience. The guys wearing suits.
Suits and ties. In the like you went out and put a tie on. It's crazy.
If you ask Dennis, he wishes we'd go back to that. Right, Dennis?
I always enjoyed wearing a shirt and tie to the audience.
Which ones were the mods?
As a broadcast professional, I think it's, you know.
Have you done radio shows with a tie on?
I would loosen it up. I would open up the top button there.
I always wear a suit to the office. Back to the Future.
Oh, right.
Oh.
I like that. It's,
That's fucking pretty badass.
I tell you, it didn't get much better than that in 1966. Good stuff.
Good stuff.
You know, it's a great song. We'll also play that on Sunday night. The flip side of Painted Black, Stupid Girl. Another good Rolling Stones song. Yeah. A lot of good B-side hits. You'd buy a 45 back in the 60s or 70s, and you'd flip it over, and you'd say, wow, this is a great song.
I would usually be like, I'm never going to play this other side of the record. I need the hit.
Right.
Well, back then, you had double-sided hits. You had,
what?
You know, Beatles
sometimes,
had
right?
Hits. Oh, Beatles had double-sided hits.
A lot of the B-sides were a waste of time, let's be honest with each other.
Later on.
Although, Hey, What Can I Do by Led Zeppelin was a B-side.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, it was.
Very good.
Which one's this?
See, I know my shit.
Yes, you do.
I know a little shit.
You know a lot
Not
of
as
stuff.
Much.
No, you know a lot of stuff. Good song.
Sounds like the Monkees.
Well, I think the Monkees might have copied that.
Oh.
Good record.
I'm not feeling this one.
No?
No.
However, so you wouldn't have flipped it over.
Nope.
Did you ever see them on Ed Sullivan, the dude, As Tears Go By?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
That's fucking great.
Ed Sully Stone.
I didn't know you liked the Stones, Jimmy.
I'm not a huge fan. I would say I'm more of a Hack Stones. I like the hits, but I like
As
a
As Tears
few.
Go By, that's a little deep.
That's one of my favorite ones.
It's kind of deep.
It is.
You like the Marianne Faithful version?
Oh, I've never seen this one. This is in color. Oh, that's enough.
That's Satisfaction.
Yeah, Sam, it's a different one. It's black and white for Pete's sake.
So why don't we go to break with this? Because we got guests coming in.
Okay. What the fuck is Sam doing?
We're going to go to break with this. God. Thank you, Dennis Falco.
Thank you, guys.
Oh, Jimmy's pick today. I love it.
Wow, it's
pussy
like
pussy machines.
It is the evening of the day.
Listen to the screaming. Holy God.
It's like the interns when I walk in the room.
Smiling faces I can see, but not for me. I sit and watch as tears go by. My riches can't buy everything. Of rain falling on the ground. I sit and watch as tears go by. It is the evening of the day. I sit and watch the children play. Tears go by.